King from Tiger King out here on the Florida Bay. Just want to let you guys know Rockstar Beer is having an online tasting and want you guys to try it out. It's some good stuff. Tiger King approved. Try it out, guys. And remember, fuck Carol Baskin. The bitch killed her husband.
That's what I meant to say. So, you know. Hi everybody, my name is Carly. I am the Southwest Market Manager for Ace Cider. So Ace Cider is a family-owned and operated cidery out of Sebastopol, California. We've been in business since 1993. Started by Jeffrey House, and most of our operations are still run by his sons, the House brothers. So Ace Cider is 100% natural cider. We don't add any additional sugars. We're typically 30 to 50% less carbs and calories than other ciders on the market. We use all 100% natural fruit juices and a 100% apple ferment instead of a apple sugar mix, which a lot of cideries tend to do. We're also gluten-free, vegan, 100% organic and all natural. So It's a pretty easy cider to get behind if you're looking for an alternative that's healthier. Simon and his brother were actually in Brazil on Ipanema Beach, and they were having a local cocktail called a caipirinha, which is a lime and sugar typically along with guava. And they thought, man, this would be really great as a cider. And so that's kind of how that idea was born. And with pineapple being very fruit forward and all of the success that we've experienced with that, it was just natural for us to go with a fruit like guava to complement that as like a tropical duo. So we are really, really pleased with how this one turned out. All right, guys, so today we are tasting the Ace Guava Cider. It's our newest release. This guy open. What a beauty. All right, cheers. This is a 5% unfiltered guava cider. We use 100% pink Brazilian guava as well as our apple blend. It's very tropical, it's very zesty, but it's also semi-sweet, has a really nice dry finish on it. I urge you just take it in before you taste it because your nose is the hallway to your taste buds. So you're gonna really enjoy this. Are you guys ready to do pub trivia with Ace Cider?
Which brewer is widely credited with creating the strain of yeast used in many lagers today? A, Heineken, B, Budweiser, C, Carlsberg, D, Beck's.
Carlsberg?
Which of the following is not a variety of hop? A, Millennium, B, Tomahawk, C, Pilgrim, D, Victory.
Tomahawk.
Nope.
Non-alcoholic beer generally contains roughly the same amount of alcohol as what kind of fruit? A, banana, B, pear, C, pineapple, D, kiwi.
Kiwi?
Nope.
How many calories can be found in a traditional pint of 5% lager? A, 185, B, 200, C, 215, D, 285.
180?
Nope.
Which brand of beer recently altered its recipe to better replicate how it tastes in its country of origin? A, Guinness, B, Asahi, C, Newcastle, D, Stella.
Newcastle.
Who is the world's largest brewer? A, Anheuser-Busch, B, China Resource, C, Miller, D, Heineken.
China.
AB. Okay, guys, thank you so much for playing along. If you need more information on Ace Cider, you can find us at www.acecider.com. You can also find us on Instagram and Facebook at Ace Cider. And you can find most of our products in Whole Foods, BevMo, Total Wine, and most of your regular grocers like Stater Brothers, Ralph's, Albertsons, all that good stuff. So thanks again, guys. Thanks for your support. Stay safe and healthy out there.
What's up, Virtual Beer Festival? Virtual Beer Festival sounds fun. Enjoy, drink up, be merry. Can't wait to see the result of in-house hedonism.
Virtual Beer Fest. Shout out Rockstar Beer. It's your boy Shwayze out here in quarantine. Hope you guys are staying safe. Want to send you guys a little bit of love from Malibu, California. You know what I'm saying. So let's do this shit, shall we? Yeah.
Maybe we be mine, come on in line. And I will be your main squeeze. And if your brother don't like my style, we can take it to the street.
Yeah.
We can take it to the street.
Little girls in the city, dress up pretty. Go out and get messed up and shitty. Girls by the sea, dress like hippies. And raw love bees and go skinny dipping. Girls in the hills, go day tripping. To get the nails done, a hair straightened. Little girls from the 818, they get hot when I roll over Laurel Canyon. Hey, let me tell you about a girl I know.
She like hip hop and rock and roll. She walks slow down the avenue. I ain't met her, but I get her when I do. Let me tell you about a girl I love. She stay at home cause she hate the club. Baby butt, pretty little features. I ain't met her, but I'll get her when I see her sing.
Look like giraffes, long neck, long legs, tiny tits and ass. Girls from LA rocked over South Shade and chill all day, cause they already paid. Girls in Miami, stream bikini on bump techno by DJ Tiesto. Girls in Detroit like electro, would dance all night till they break their neck, yo. Let me tell you about a girl I know. She like hip hop and rock and roll. Let me tell you about a girl I love. Let me tell you about a girl I love. Let's go.
Yo, brother, don't like my style. What you gon' do? We can take it to the street. We can take it to the street. And if your brother don't like my style,
what you gon' do?
We can take it to the street. We can take it to the street.
Look, now if you're looking for love, won't you put your hands up? Hey. hey, hey. Cause if you looking for love, you know I'm looking for love, huh? Yeah, yeah, look. Now if you're looking for weed, won't you put your hands up? Yeah, cause if you looking for weed, you know I'm looking for weed, right? And you better give me some. I said, let me tell you about a girl I know. She like hip-hop and rock and roll. She walks slow down the avenue. I ain't mad about her, get her when I do. Let me tell you about a girl I love. She stay at home cause she hate the club.
Baby butt, pretty little features. I ain't mad about her, get her when I see her. Maybe we be mine, come on in line. And I will be your main squeeze.
Gonna do?
We can take it to the street.
Yeah.
We can take it to the street.
I'm a lover, not a fighter, though. Hey, hey, hey. But I will be yo. Hey, hey, hey. And if your brother don't like my style, we gon' hey. Virtual Beer Fest. Much love. Your boy Shwayze. Stay Shwasted.
What's the crazy? Oh man. My name is Stephen Miles. I am the founder and CEO of Noble Aleworks. We were established in 2009, so we're in our 11th year. The first craft brewery in Anaheim, and we're proud to be the pioneers of that. Our tradition is West Coast style, hop forward, West Coast, you know, Southern California, some of the greats like Stone, Alpine, kind of some of the people that we were inspired by, Green Flash back in the early days. So we make a lot of hop forward single, double IPA, and even session IPA. We are known for double IPA mostly due to the success of Nobility, which won gold medal in World Beer Cup, I mean at the World Beer Cup and at Great American Beer Festival. In 2018. It's also won a silver medal and a gold and a bronze medal, so it's kind of run the gamut. This is our German lager. We call it Vacay all day, just based on the, you know, the crushability of it. You know, when you think of a good crisp Pilsner or a German style lager, you want to be drinking it on a day like this when it's a little hot, and you just want to be able to take it down. So we called it Vacay all day, because we always feel like we're on vacation when you get a little warm weather and a nice ice cold crushable beer. So this has it's Czech saaz hops on it, so it's very traditional. And it's really one of our, since we've been putting this out, it's one of our kind of mainstays now, and really a kind of a crowd favorite for that spectrum of beer style. We've meddled in single IPA and in session IPA, nose candy. The first year that Session IPA was a category for the Great American Beer Festival, Nose Candy medaled. And this was kind of our first medal, so it was an extra special moment for us. I mean, it's just a classic style of beer that we make, which is just a very hop-forward, all-hop aroma, and a very kind of, you know, having malt take second stage to the aroma on your nose, hence the name. So. And Nose Candy, as I mentioned earlier, this was our first medal on a national stage at Great American Beer Festival. It won a bronze medal the first year that Session IPA was a category. This is a Session IPA is basically a beer that's all about the hops. It's a lower ABV, 4.4, 4.5 range. So all it's about is getting that massive dank, piney, floral, citrusy-like aroma, and in your palate. So this is basically a mosaic session IPA. We feel mosaic is by far the best hop to use in a session IPA. There's also a handful of other hops in it: Equinaut, Simcoe, Chinook. So, but again, the driving force is mosaic, and this is This is for the person that likes that aroma. A lot of people will be like, wow, and then other people will be like, ee. So it depends on your preference, but this is one of my all-time favorites. Well, thanks everyone for taking a few moments out of your day to listen to me ramble. But we're glad to have you, and I hope you enjoy these beers. I'm gonna be drinking this Vacay right now because it's kind of hot right now, and so I hope you enjoy it.
Hey gang, group, gang, what's up? It's me, Dave Koechner from Rockstar Beer Festivals. Yeah, it's me from that. I am that. So listen, just a virtual shout out. I know you're getting some beers at your houses, and we're doing this thing together. Rockstar Beer Festivals. So much more fun to say it that way. Anyway, you got some booze, come to your house. Let's do it. Hey gang, let's talk beer. Let's talk brews. Is there anything better than that enjoyment of those suds? There's a quote about God inventing beer. I forget what it is. Somebody there at Rockstar Beer Festival will know it. I don't know it, but harangue them into finding it. But God invented beer. Who made it better? I'll tell you who made it better. Rockstar Beer Festival. They made it better. So are they God? Wow. A preponderance. Whammy!
If you're going to make good beer, you know, try to do it in a place that's the most competitive. And so that's why we're in San Diego, and it's been great the past 8 years. Beer is the ultimate social uniter. And that's why it's called Societe, because beer is for everyone in society. So we've never shot for like the, let's see how much we can push the limits in terms of flavor profiles. And let's see if we can make a beer that tastes like, I don't know, a chocolate cake. Because if I want a chocolate cake, I'll eat a chocolate cake. If I want a beer, I want it to taste like beer. The way to push the envelope is not necessarily how to add new ingredients to beer, but more, you know, for example, when I drink an IPA, and I love IPAs, it's like, how can I get more hop aroma and flavor in my face faster, more efficiently? You know, I want the intensity there. You know, how do we do that? Like, so what are different process techniques that we can take to get you that experience? When you're tasting beer, when I'm tasting beer, you have to remember that aroma is most of what's going on that you're getting into your olfactory senses. So taste is really bitterness, sweetness, umami, salt, and sour. Everything else is really an aroma. So even though you put the beer in your mouth, or you put whatever it is, you know, food in your mouth, a lot of it's coming back up. And that's how you're tasting it, is the aroma.
Okay, just rub them together. All right, let's smell it. Here's number one.
Oh God.
Only use it. Alright, smell those hands again. And you're ready for number two. So tell us, number one or number two? Which one is the pupil?
I'm gonna say number two is pupil.
You win!
Right. You got it right, man. Number two is the pupil. You are good.
There is no wrong way to taste and drink beer. If you're having fun, you're doing it the right way. So I just want to leave you guys with that. And if you don't like a beer, it's totally okay. The best part about beer is the discovery. That's the number one thing, is discover, explore, and kind of, you know, you find yourself in it. So I think that's it.
Hey guys, Jeff and Lauren from the Netflix show Tiger King. This goes out to our friends at Virtual Beer Festival. Apparently you guys are all sitting around home drinking craft beers and enjoying a virtual beer tasting.
Save some for me.
That's pretty original, I gotta say. Wouldn't it be easier just to kind of sneak into somebody's garage and open it up as a club and just really drink beer in front of each other? That's what I would do. Thank you guys, but I'm a rule breaker, you know that. Thank you guys for watching the show and for your support. We love you all. We want you all to stay safe and keep your family safe. And when this pandemic is over, come and see us at the park. We'd love to have you guys. And we'll drink beer together without virtual. Yeah. Bye, guys.
Harland Brewing Company. I'm here with Nick Roan, Director of Brewery Operations. How are you doing?
Good. Good to be here.
So this all started with a couple of guys over down at St. Archer. You want to give us a story about Harland Brewing Company?
Yeah. You know, St. Archer started in 2013. I was there from almost day one, about a month in, and you know, the business was sold to Miller Coors. And after the original owners and some of the leadership team got out of working for St. Archer, they stayed out of beer for a little bit and then wanted to get back into it. So, you know, what we're doing here is a little different. It's not really the same approach as we had over there. And, you know, we're looking to make some different beers, some interesting beers, and be more engaged with the local community. We started brewing here in June. We opened a tasting room in Del Mar in August, and then we opened this tasting room in November. And this community loves beer, and they love to be able to come to their local brewery. And so, I mean, we've had fans from day one that have just been people who live right in the apartments around the corner or are driving here from all over the county.
Do you have like a loyalty card for those guys that come every day? Or
You know, you get to know them and, you know, you take care of them a little bit.
Almost like family.
That's right. Cheers. Exactly.
So right now we're about to taste the Hazy IPA. You want to give us like a background on what a Hazy IPA is and
what makes your guys' is different?
Yeah, so Hazy's are, you know, there's a million of them out there these days. They originally kind of came from New England, some breweries on the East Coast that were making these things. And the goal is really to be an aromatic, hop-forward IPA, like you see with the West Coast style, but with a reduced bitterness and a soft mouthfeel. So this is our Hazy IPA. It's an IPA brewed with cashmere, azaka, and Southern Cross hops. A lot of malted oats, a lot of unmalted wheat, so it's got a really creamy, bready mouthfeel, and big notes of citrus, tangerine, lemon peel, a little bit of a tropical fruit note, and some slight sweetness on the back end.
Hi, my name's Tommy Hadges. I'm the general manager for Left Coast Brewing Company out of San Clemente, California. Left Coast Brewing Company started in 2004, right here in San Clemente. It's a family-run business. My parents actually started it, my parents and my uncle. It's me, my sister, my cousin are also involved. And we were from San Clemente, went to high school here, and we decided to open up the brewery in our hometown. What we're all about here is consistency and high quality. We're not necessarily known for having a bunch of limited beers, although we love to do them. We have beers like Galaxy Supernova IPA that we do and other one-offs throughout the year. But we're known for beers like Hop Juice and Trestles IPA. We have some staple beers in our lineup that have been around for years that we can't afford to take out of the lineup to be able to make these limited beers. We're very lucky that way. We have placements throughout all of California with these beers consistently selling. So that's really how we're different, is that we don't constantly rotate through new beers. We like to really hone in and make the beers that we make fantastic. Trestles IPA is a beer that's very near and dear to our hearts. It's a local surf spot here in San Clemente, so that makes it very special to us, to the community. Very awesome surf spot here in San Clemente. All the surfers love it. It's famous around the world. People come here from Hawaii, from Japan, and the first thing they want to try is Trestles IPA, which is pretty cool just because of the name. Sometimes they don't realize that it's an IPA and they get a little bit shocked when they get that bitterness on their tongue, but it's okay. But as far as the flavor profiles of the Trestles IPA, it's been around a long time and it's evolved just like our Hop Juice Triple IPA. It's been around since maybe 2008 or 9. And when we first made it, it was considered a new school style IPA. You know, it wasn't as malty, it was more hop forward. This beer is very balanced. It's got a little bit of a malt backbone. It's not gonna be the new school style IPA that has, you know, all the Mosaic, Citra, and Nelson all punching out at you. What it's gonna have is a nice, smooth, balanced IPA with tropical grapefruit kind of aromas and flavor, but it doesn't stand out majorly. It more blends together, and it's a very smooth IPA. So I hope you enjoy one of the two of the beers that you got in your box, either Hop Juice Triple IPA or Trestles IPA. Hopefully it's everything to your standards and you enjoy. They're very, very fresh. They were canned this week. So only the best product is going out to this thing. So hopefully you like them. Okay, so you guys ready for round two of trivia with Left Coast?
In the brewing process, the fermentation step turns sugar into alcohol and what else?
Carbon dioxide, CO2.
What causes skunked beer? A, bad yeast. B, heat. C, old age. D, light.
Light.
Which country consumes the most beer per capita? A, USA. B, Czech Republic. C, Ireland. Or D, Germany?
Czech Republic.
A session beer usually has which characteristic?
B. In a standard American keg that has no gallons or ounces with it, like it's a 15.5 gallon
yep.
keg, okay, that's a standard keg.
Yep.
And you said how many 12 ounce?
12 ounce beers.
In a 15.5 gallon keg, let's see here, 12 ounce, there are 168. It was a pleasure hanging out with you guys for the virtual beer festival. Hope you guys are staying safe at home, drinking some awesome beer, not getting too buzzed, especially if you have kids, and staying healthy.
Spencer Chambers, founder, owner, and brewer at Honest Abe Cider and Southern California Cider Company. I founded Honest Abe Cider back in 2014. I was the first guy in all Southern California to start a hard cider company. I grew up in a dry county in Kentucky, and it was a moonshine country, so everybody made homemade wines and homebrewed, but nobody made beer. We made a lot of cider. So I got to LA, and nobody else in Southern California was making hard cider, so I started up Honest Abe, and Abe Lincoln is from Kentucky, so the name is a homage to the roots. We've got hundreds of accounts all over LA. We're in Disney California Adventure on tap there. Been part of the Rockstar Beer Fest since the very beginning. So excited to be with you here during these crazy times and doing it this way. The process for making cider is more like a wine. It's actually done under a wine license. Cider is technically just apple wine. Whenever we can, we source local ingredients in some of our ciders. We got a local honey we get from farmers down in Temecula. It's a local wildflower honey. The apples, some small batches we get from farmers up around Big Bear. It's always a blend of sweet and tart, and they got some heirloom apples. Bigger and bigger, we get some apples from NorCal and all West Coast though, some Washington and Oregon as well. But how it works is you grind and press the apples, and then take the apple juice and ferment that. You add yeast. All our ciders are done with a champagne yeast to give it a nice dry, crisp finish. So nothing real sweet and syrupy, good, easy drinking stuff. Since we're a small batch producer, we had to send out a few different varieties to cover everybody here at the Virtual Beer Fest. So some of you are getting Honest Abe ciders, and some of you are actually getting our new brand, the from the Southern California Cider Company as well. I hope you'll find them all delicious. Low in sugar, low in carbs, gluten-free, super tasty. So cheers to all you guys.
About to play a game called Who Said This? You ready?
I'm ready.
Tell you a quote, and you're just gonna tell me who said it. Could be a historian, could be someone famous, we don't know.
Okay.
Folks are usually as generally happy as they ought to be.
Honest Abe, Abe Lincoln.
Yep. Life is a crazy ride and nothing is guaranteed.
Aerosmith.
Eminem.
Ah, shit. I was close.
If I were Two-Face, would it be wearing this face?
Joker.
Ooh, that was actually Abraham Lincoln. My favorite. I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like them. Sam, I am.
Is that the Cat in the Hat? Or Dr. Seuss? Or,
yeah, Dr. Yeah? Seuss.
Okay.
To the window, to the wall, till the sweat drips down my balls.
Oh, I say that all the time, but I think originally it was,
It's a recent famous person.
Yeah. Yeah, I know the song. I can't think of it though.
Yeah.
Oh, it's on the tip of my tongue. Little Wayne.
One of the Little John.
Little John, there it is, yeah.
Yeah, boy. What's up, Virtual Beer Fest? How's everybody doing out there? Hope you're staying home, staying safe, drinking a lot. I've prepared a beautiful classic tune for you guys to sing along with at home. I think you're going to know the words, and I think you're going to love it.
Three, six, nine, damn, you're fine. Suck it, suck it, suck it to me, baby, one more time. To the windows, to the walls, till the sweat drops down my balls. All these bitches crawl, all skeet skeet motherfucker, all skeet skeet goddamn, all skeet skeet motherfucker, all skeet skeet goddamn. Shorty crunk, So fresh, so clean, can she fuck? The question been harassing me in the mind. The bitch is fine, I done came to the club about 50 damn times. Can I play with your panty line? Club owner said I need to calm down. Security guard gonna sweat me now. Junker than a motherfucker threaten me now. 369, damn you're fine. Suck it, suck it, suck it to me, baby, one more time. To the windows, to the walls, to the sweat drops down my balls. All you bitches crawl. She coming up in the club, I mean she working. And I like to see the females twerking. Taking her clothes off, fucking naked. ATL hoe, don't disrespect it. Pop your pussy like this, cuz yin yang twins in this B.I.H. Lil Jon and the East Side Boys are with me. We all like to see the massive titties. 369, sing it. Damn, you're fine. Suck it, suck it, suck it to me, baby, one more time. To the windows, to the walls, to the sweat drops down my balls. All you bitches crawl, sing. I'll skeet, skeet, motherfucker. I'll skeet, skeet, goddamn. Oh, skeet, skeet, motherfucker. Oh, skeet, skeet, goddamn. Bang, bang, back it up. 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 Stop. Wiggle with it, yeah, stop. And wiggle with it, yeah, stop. And wiggle with it, yeah. Sing it with me at home. 369, damn, you're fine. Suck it, suck it, suck it to me, baby, one more time. To the windows, to the walls, to the sweat drops down my balls. All you bitches crawl. All skeet, skeet, motherfucker. All skeet, skeet, goddamn. All skeet, skeet, motherfucker. All skeet, skeet, goddamn. Here we go. Extra charge on that one. Thank you.